Life on tour is all about getting ready for the hour and a half that you're on stage. And like, as bored as you are during the day, you're trying to find something better to do, and you know, there's a lot of downtime and people are setting up and loading all the gear and everything. Then you get that hour and a half on stage and it makes everything completely worth it. Yeah, this is the second time that we've played Madison Square Garden to have an opportunity to headline there. Just really an incredible feeling as an artist. Most of the shows have been larger capacities than the Garden, but you really have to up your game and do something special. Life on tour is very, very different than life at home. You really have to just abandon yourself and just enjoy every second of it. Every day, you wake up at like 11 or noon, you stumble off the bus, the lights are way too bright outside, the sun's always glaring, you feel like Dracula walking into the sun. So you're just standing there to look around for a sign that points you in the right direction. Oh no, my wife wouldn't like that. You know, I gotta go run and do sound check right quick. Well, when we first started writing music, our influences were really from like the Southern California skate punk rock community. And now we have about 15 years worth of material to choose from. So we wanted to make a set list that was very dynamic. As friends and as musicians, Tom and I just clicked right away. We have the same sense of humor, we like the same bands. We were automatically finishing each other's sentences, both literally and musically. And when Travis joined the band, I feel it was when Blink really found itself. It's a jazz bass body with a precision bass neck on it. And I put Seymour Duncan quarter pound pickups in here. And this is one volume knob, no tone.
It's not a bunch of bells and whistles. This is the workhorse of rock and roll. It's a really melodic bass player.
I would never stop playing music. It's an amazing, incredible, humbling thing to get to do what we do, and I don't think that any of us would stop for anything. Your smile fades in the summer. I don't think I prepare mentally. I just get excited to go out on stage and start things. Short this time, your smile fades in the summer. From the moment that we walk in after sound check, I'm checking my watch every 10 minutes to see how soon till we get to play. I just really want to get up there and do our thing. Where do we go from here? I grew up skating in Southern California, so I really come out of that culture. And I'm most comfortable in a t-shirt, a pair of shorts, and a pair of sneakers. I'm not a dude that dresses up. I'm not a high fashion guy. There's a lot of dudes that can pull off the scruffy look, but I'm not one of them. I've always had ridiculous looking hair, and I kind of wear it as a badge of honor that it takes a village to make my hair look like this every day. I'm the dude walking into the hotel with a flat iron and blow dryer. It's not a good look. I pretty much every night before I go on stage have a moment where I think, can I pull this off tonight? Is this gonna happen? And I try and change that into a more positive energy. And so I start warming up my voice, stretch out. I usually get my wrist wrapped to make sure that I brush my teeth. I don't know if it actually helps me sing, but I feel like it clears out my singing passages. Faith fell short this time, your smile fades in the summer. I'll definitely be nervous tonight playing Madison Square Garden because it's such a monumental venue. Ready for a show?
Yes, I am, sir.
Playing here, you're held to such a high standard because you're playing in New York City. You definitely feel the pressure and you want to do the best you can. It's really the anticipation of waiting to go on stage that starts to get me crazy. 10 feet away, thousands of people, just waiting for that curtain to drop is the most amazing feeling in the world.